conversation going on over there. Hi, I want to say hi to the cute guy on the desk.
Say hello to Matt Money Smith.
Hi, Matt.
Right over here.
Come on.
Okay. The guy with the glasses and always works for us.
I tell you what, Matt, since you're here and you can do this, I was going to read the whole Kings thing. Go ahead.
Okay. Yeah, well, it is one game away for the Kings. They are one win away from their first Stanley Cup ever.
Ever.
Back along the half boards and dug out there by Lewis. He's got it around in front. Oh, and a save by Brodeur. And another save by Brodeur. They come from him. They score.
And that second period goal by Alec Martinez, all the Kings would need last night. They beat the Devils 4-0 to take a 3-0 lead. Matt Money Smith from AM570 Sports LA is
when
right
is
here.
When is he coming in?
Right
I can't
here.
Wait.
Who would have ever guessed? Yes, it's great to be here, Betty, Steve.
Who's that guy you work with?
Petros.
Okay, he's a local kid,
yes,
right?
Yes, local kid made good, exactly. He actually, he's a father. Just had, they just welcomed their first son.
Yes, Papadakis.
Fletcher Petros Papadakis.
What a name,
that's,
Fletcher
Papadakis. Say that fast five times.
we were having fun here. Suddenly we're a hockey town, you know? Listen, we're all front runners, we all love winners, et cetera. This town has never been a passionate, you got 100, 200,000 passionate hockey fans, and the rest of the people don't pay that much attention. What's happened here?
Well, I would say this. Get down to LA Live. Get down to Staples Center tomorrow. We're going to start our broadcast. I've been doing it with Jim Fox, who, of course, has been affiliated.
He knows a few things about
it. Just a few things. Yeah. Played with the Kings for 9 years, been on the broadcast for 22. We're doing 5 hours of pregame. And you know what? People get there. We started at noon yesterday. People started showing up at 12:30. 1:30, the street is packed.
Wow.
2:30, like you said, all of those hockey fans have descended on that part of town.
I think it's to see you, Money.
It is not to see me. Maybe to see Jim Fox, but you know, you said it. They're the best fans. I mean, that 100 to 200,000 group, it's the best collection of fans in LA.
A million years ago, the guy who owned the Chicago Blackhawks said, in Chicago, there are 2 million Cubs fans and 2 million White Sox fans. I have 50,000 Blackhawks fans, and I'll sell out 25,000 every night.
Yeah, he's absolutely right. Yeah. Exact same thing. That, you know what, Staples, think about this. Staples Center has been at capacity 100% the entire season, 101% last season. They sell out standing room. So those fans are dedicated.
So do they welcome everybody else, or are they a little annoyed that the rest of us are bandwagoning?
I think they're annoyed, no question. It's like music, you know, the indie rock band.
Sure.
They become popular.
It's only ours.
On the radio.
It's ours.
This belongs to
us. You were cool when no one liked them.
Right.
Exactly.
You know, in 93 was different because it was Gretzky. You know, I mean, it was that galvanizing force across all sports.
How's he feeling right about now?
He's excited. We talked to him yesterday.
Yeah. Well, Gretzky fit the narrative here. Then he was like a Hollywood star playing hockey.
Right.
These are hockey players playing
hockey.
Yes,
we've got Dustin Brown, who's missing his teeth. You have Andrzej Kopitar, the Slovenian. You have Jonathan Quick, the very humble, quiet goaltender that stops everything that's put his way.
I'm always worried that Quick is going to pull a ligament in his legs.
He's so athletic. You know, the old hockey term is standing on your head. You know, he is putting together, after last night's shutout, the greatest postseason in the history of the NHL by a goaltender, stopping 95% of the shots that he has faced, not just in the final, but in the Stanley Cup playoffs. This is the best. I mean, you go back to the 50s when people were saying, you know, pip, pip, and good show. I mean, that's how far back you have
to go.
Nobody
said
pip, pip. You weren't there in the 50s. You weren't there in the 50s.
I was there with Gump Worsley and Jacques Plante.
How about that?
How's that?
How about that pull right there? I thought you were going to go Rocket Richard or something.
Oh, please. Come on.
Jeez. How about Steve?
Yeah.
I thought I was supposed to be the sports guy.
I mean, back then, they truly didn't have teeth. Now they fake not having teeth.
Yeah.
It's different, right?
They pull them out for the game and
they
put them back in afterwards.
Exactly. You're very excited. I want to ask you a bigger question before you go. Is L.A., we were talking about this, is L.A. a great sports town? Because Betty was saying, you know, if you're in Dallas, Texas, or somewhere else.
I remember the Dallas Stars. Yeah. When they were winning that Stanley Cup, everyone came out. It was crazy. It was mayhem.
Right.
Here. It's kind of like,
are we too blasé here?
No, I don't think so. And it's a good comparison with the Stars because, you know,
they
moved from Minnesota. They got to the Stanley Cup final rather quickly.
Right.
So it was like they didn't have to go through any of the trials and tribulations. You know this, Steve.
Sure.
You've been here, you know, since, when was it? The
50s?
But I mean, look, you talk about the Kings, 67 expansion, 45 years. It's been nothing but heartbreak. 93, it was heartbreak. Yesterday was the 19th anniversary of Game 2, the curve stick. I mean, there's
curve
a lot.
Stick. Marty McSorley. Yeah.
Exactly. A lot of bad luck associated with this team.
But they never got the negative on them like the Clippers always had.
Right. Exactly. Because you know what? Those fans are passionate. And regardless of what happened, they stuck with them and the place was always packed.
Last question. Do you believe in the Clippers now?
The Clippers, they got to prove something to me. You know, I want to. I love Chris Paul. I love Blake Griffin. I'd love to see the Clippers prove something to me. taken that next step. Ownership, much they got to do.
So you think it's going to be a sweep? I know you're pulling for a sweep.
Sweep. Here's what I would say. What? Go out there. You know, we talked to our friend Barry from Barry's Tickets yesterday. Tickets were $450 to get in upstairs.
You've got to shout his name. You have to shout his name.
Barry!
Okay.
Exactly. Like Ben Chris does.
And some tickets are $11,000? Are you kidding me?
$450 to get into that building, the electricity inside, you can't beat it.
Wow.
I can't recommend
Matt
it enough.
Matt DeGray, thank you. Good to see you. Tomorrow, what time do you start?
Tomorrow we start at noon out there at Chick Hearn Court between Staples and LA Live with Jim Fox.
Matt Money Smith, thank you. George Lopez is with us. And also from Pretty Little Liars, Janelle Parrish. And Far East Movement is here as well. And Adopt-A-Pet and Adopt-A-Bill Handle.
Good day, L.A.